sandbar all the way out to those breakers here.
They say what, about a mile?
Could be a mile, actually a mile that you could actually walk on the sandbar.
The sea is a desert of waves, a wilderness of water. Langston Hughes.
Just came in and put Shelby down there along the wall.
After our arrival in Spanish Wells, we hurried in before the sun went down to get our first glimpse of the town and head up the hill to Buddha's for a beer. We were able to snag our first Sands beer here. The Sands Brewery was flooded during Hurricane Dorian and will not be open again until August, and sadly we prefer Sands to Kalik. But beggars cannot be choosers. Buddha's introduced us to Virginia, our bartender, who was born and raised in Spanish Wells, and we got some local info about the island. More exploring to come. We need to get back on the boat before sunset and ready for the next day.
We are in Spanish Wells and we're walking out to the Atlantic side. It's supposed to be a really nice beach area. It looks like it's high tide, but as you can see them breaking out there, it's supposed to be a sandbar all the way out to those breakers here.
They say what? About a mile?
Could be a mile, actually a mile that you could actually walk on the sandbar.
Yeah.
It's gonna be high tide now. Low tide.
That's what, like a 10-minute walk from the inside to outside?
Yes, very small island, but where we dinghy, we have to kind of climb up a wall, walk up a hill, and then you walk back down the hill to this side. Spanish Wells kind of sits on a little hill.
Yep, down there to the bay side and turn around down to the Atlantic side. You can see the water right through the trees there.
We enjoyed getting a glimpse of the Atlantic and the beautiful beach, looking out towards the Devil's Backbone. The island was used as a last stop for Spanish ships returning to Europe. Ships refilled their water supply from the Wales, thus the English name of the settlement, Spanish Wales. The first British colonists were the Eleutheran adventurers from Bermuda, intending to be some of the first settlers of Eleuthera, who suffered a shipwreck on the reef known as the Devil's Backbone in 1647. After living in a cave known as Preacher's Cave, they ended up at Spanish Wells. Among other later groups of settlers were the Crown Loyalists, who left the United States after the American Revolutionary War.
Now on Leo Pender Road, which a lot of things named Pender around here. Obviously have a connection to a family. I'll look that up and try to tell you about it later. We're walking down here to the food fair, which is supposed to be a pretty decent sized grocery store. And the only one that's really convenient for cruisers in Eleuthera. So we're gonna get definitely some fruits and vegetables and maybe bread. So those are things that, you know, we've already kind of run short of with all the weather we've been through. And then let's see what we can pick up as we move down what is available, but this may be the last really big stop for us for a while, so we'll check out what they've got.
That's how close it is. We've been to the food fair, got some groceries, vegetables mainly.
There's your old cars, babe.
After groceries, we could actually explore the little island. First, to walk along the dock wall, I'd asked a question about all the cars on this little island. What happens to them? Well, it appears they go out to sea. Next question, how do boats come out of the water to be worked on in Spanish Wells? Well,
should be the little road.
very, very busy.
Has to come up first.
We continue our walk around this beautiful little island. We're heading over to Meek's Patch to ride out some weather, but we'll be back to Spanish Wells for one last look before we leave. Last visit into Spanish Wells, we found the school and the cemetery full of Pender names. While in the Pender grocery store, we met the owner, of course, Mr. Pender, and he enjoyed telling us about his travels around the world and his project of documenting every house on the island. So I remember now to look up the Pender name. Lots of stories about the Penders, from there just being two Penders that settled here to, well, something might just be a little strange in the air here in Spanish Wells. Either way, these are super nice people, that beautiful little island that we enjoyed. But it's time for us to move further south.
So we're getting fuel at St. George Power Company. They make, they have diesel fuel here. And I've heard it's really good because it's produced here. Although it says St. George Power Company, we are just off the anchorage from Spanish Wells. And we just got her in here on this little dock. Here's this cool little cave area right in here. And it would be an awesome little snorkel spot. These little houses on the cliffs. These cool little overlooking porches. Guys up there working on the roof, and we're up here. We're getting our fuel, topping her off. Her just really good fuel here. And then those boats way out there. That's where we're going to Current Cut today. Current Cut, here we come.
We're off. We haven't had this kind of smooth water in quite some time. we're going to hopefully enjoy it, at least until we get to current cut. And we're trying to time it with the tide so it's not as strong as it can be. 6 to 10 knots is at its peak, and we don't want to hit it at that time. As I said before, we just left Spanish Wells, and quite a few boats are out here this morning, and it looks like we are all headed down to current cut. We have heard it is to be very respected, and after Fleming Cut was so rough, we are a little concerned. We're about 6 miles from current cut, and the water is very smooth and clear, and we will try to capture some of it to share. See them up there, but a few more sailboats and another boat out in front of it going to the same place we're all going. Current cut, which goes into Eleuthera Bay. And we're going, most likely all of us, to Hatchet Bay, Anchorage, to get away from a big blow that's coming this weekend.
Made it to current cut just at slack tide like we had hoped. Everything we read and heard about this cut was a little scary. And looking at how narrow the cut is that connects two big bodies of water, it was a little intimidating. Our ride through the cut was smooth and fine with little help from the current. Now we're headed through Eleuthera Bay down to Hatchet Bay for our next adventure.
Notice it when you get there. Oh yeah, 'cause no other island.